All right, I'm going to be going over page 25 and 26 in your packet. Now, I did add some things here. I added just some things to reference. So I added O. Remember, that is the opposite leg. It is across from the reference angle. We've got A, adjacent leg, which is next to the reference angle. And then we've got our hypotenuse. So anytime you're looking at one of these problems, you want to first identify the side that you are solving for and the side that you know. So here's my reference angle. We are solving for this side here, X, and we know this side here, 14. Okay, so a couple things. The first thing is you may want to always identify or create an L with the legs. So these two sides are legs. We know that the legs are created with the right angle, those two sides there. So if these two sides are legs, that means the 14, that has to be our hypotenuse side. And remember, it is across from the right angle, directly opposite to it. So we know 14 is the hypotenuse. And then we just have to identify, okay, from the 65 degree angle, what type of side is X? Is it next to 65 degrees or is it across from 65 degrees? Well, here's the 65, here's the side, they are right next to each other. So then I'm going to label that with an A for adjacent. And then this side that's blank, I'm just going to leave it blank because we're not really solving for that in this problem. And we don't know that side. And so I have an A and H. I added this here as well. So I'm going to select the cosine ratio. That would be the ratio we could use to solve for the missing side in this triangle. So we can set this up. C is for cosine. So cosine of our angle measures, our reference angle, 65 degrees, is equal to A, which is X, over H, which is 14. And then from here, you're just solving for your variable. So we could say X would multiply with 1 if I did a cross product. 14 would multiply with cosine of 65. So making sure that you have this on your paper, you want to make sure you're labeling these two sides. You want to make sure you're writing out the equation that you're using to solve an exact answer. An exact answer is what we put into our calculator. And then we're going to get the approximation for that. So we'll do 14 cosine 65. So 14, and you can either press the button here or you just type in cosine 65. And so what we've got is 5.916. So 916, I would round 916 to 917, so 5.917. Okay, so that's question 17. I'm going to do a few questions with you as kind of examples. Let's try one more. So anytime I'm looking at a problem, the first thing I might want to do is identify the two sides that form the right angle. Those are the legs. So these two sides are the legs. That means this X side, that's our hypotenuse. It's directly opposite the right angle. My right angle here corner almost points to that side. Okay. And then we just have to identify from our reference angle. So we have our angle here of 17 degrees. We want to know, is the side 18 next to that or is it opposite to that? So if I trace out this angle 17 here, it is this side below is the side that's next to it. So that means this side is opposite to it. It's across. We've got an opposite leg. So then I would say, okay, O and H, an opposite and a hypotenuse, I'm going to use a sine ratio. So then we can write this out as the sine of our reference angle, 17 degrees, is equal to 18 divided by X. So that's the equation we would use to solve. Now, when we're solving, remember what anytime your variable's in the denominator, we are going to end up dividing, but this is why. X would multiply to the sine of 17 if we're trying to isolate it. And then that would equal 18 here. Now, the only way to get X by itself in this problem then would be to divide by the sine of 17 on both sides, because right now it's being multiplied by that. So what that means is we've got X is equal to 18 divided by sine of 17. And that's our exact answer. That's what we type into our calculator. And then the approximation for that, 18 divided by sine 17. Oops. And that would be 61.565. And we'll leave it as is. So 61.565. Okay. And then I'm going to try a few problems with you on the next page as well. Actually, let's do one. I'll do one more on this page. One more. That's a tangent ratio. So I'm going to move myself over here. Okay. So I'm going to do question 20 with you. So we've got on this question, I like to identify these two sides here. These are the legs. And so our hypotenuse is blank. We are not using a hypotenuse to help us with this problem. So we're definitely not using sine. We're not using cosine. We're using tangent. Now we just have to figure out, well, which is the opposite leg and which is the adjacent leg. And this is actually oriented like our slope triangle, right? So this side is opposite. This side is adjacent next to. So opposite and adjacent from that reference angle of 42 degrees. Okay. So we should be able to set this up as tan 42 is equal to opposite over adjacent. Now, if we did a cross product here, we'd get x multiplied to 1. We'd get 13 multiplied to the tangent of 42. That means x is approximately, let's go ahead and calculate that. That'd be 11.705. And then just one other thing I want to give you a reminder of where this came from. Slope tool. With our slope tool, I like to take away these grid lines in the back. There we go. And you can see the triangle a little more clearly. So remember, this is our slope ratio, just these two sides divided by each other. Let's actually test this out. So we had the 42 degree angle. So let's make this into 42 degrees. And then the bottom side here was 13. So let's make this a 13. And let's check if the triangle that we actually created was this triangle is the same triangle that we created. We've got 11.705. So the slope tool is really just a triangle creator. We can create a triangle that's a right triangle with any angle here, and then we can kind of figure out what we want the bottom side to be, the change in x, adjacent side, and it will tell us what our change in y is. So we've created the identical triangle that we've got here on this problem. Okay. So this is what you're going to do for page 25. And then on page 26, the only difference here is that the triangles are not all oriented like a slope triangle. So they're kind of rotated around, they're reflected. So let's just kind of set up a few of these so you can see. I always like to, again, highlight, or, you know, kind of connect these two sides here. These are my legs because they're formed from the right angle. That means this side here is the hypotenuse. It's directly opposite the right angle. The little corner of the right angle points to it. Then all you need to figure out is, well, 17 next to the 68 degrees, or is it across from the 68 degrees? Well, it's next to. So this would be adjacent. So that's a cosine ratio. And then I will let you set up the problem after that. And then here we've got our, I'm going to highlight my two legs. Okay, so our hypotenuse is blank. We're not using that. That means we're not using sine or cosine. It has to be a tangent ratio. So really then all you need to do is look at and say, okay, well, from 46 degrees, this side is opposite to it. This side here is adjacent. It is next to. So I'm going to use a tangent ratio. And then let's look at this example here. So again, highlight or identify the legs. These two sides are legs. Opposite the right angle is the hypotenuse. Then we would say, okay, we're using a hypotenuse, so it's not tangent. We can get rid of that. But now we just need to know if it's sine or cosine. From this 46 degree angle, this side 11 is across. It's opposite to that. So this one would be a sine ratio.